So what your question is, what is waking up or what is realization?
Why we use the terms dream and waking
Why we
up?
use the
And
term dream
the
and
exactly
waking?
like ending
Because
this reality and waking up into a new reality.
so this is what our present life, what we are experiencing, is almost like a dream-like situation. It's not, we think it's real, but it's a dream-like situation. Because there are many, many similarities with this dream and a waking condition. For example, you had a dream yesterday night. In the dream, you saw a big palace, or saw a big city, you went there and all. But when waking up, you said, all but dream, it's not real. Because a mental projection. There cannot be a city in my head. Okay, that's why it's unreal. Okay. So, in the dream, the city and your body appear together and disappear. So, the same thing is happening in the waking condition also. When you wake up in the morning, the body appears and the world appears. And when you go to sleep, the body appears and world disappears. And another dream world appears and dream world disappears. In deep sleep, both disappear. So, it's appear and disappearing. Okay? So, from that perspective, it is a projection in consciousness. It's a projection. It's not real. It's an appearance. Because it keeps changing. It keeps getting projected. And when you are experiencing the dream, it appears to be real. And when you are experiencing the waking state, that also appears to be real. And at any point of time, you cannot distinguish what is waking and what is real, what is dream. Because both are apparently real. But because of changing states of waking, dreaming, deep sleep state, you see that these are alternating, these are not real. These are like a more like a projection. So, when you from a dream, if you wake up, you will come into waking state. From waking state, if you wake up, what will you come to? Is the question. So, from the waking state, if you wake up, you recognize that everything what's happening is unreal or a projection of the mind, as equivalent, exactly similar to a projection of the mind in the dream state. In the dream, you went to a city, a beautiful city, and did some purchases. In the waking state, the city doesn't, you say the city and the purchases are all unreal. So, when you wake up from this waking state, you realize that everything what you consider your life as a life actually or the world is not there. It's a clarity, intellectual understanding which happens, a deep intellectual understanding. Unlike waking up from a dream into a waking body, waking up state, waking from the waking state called Maya, there are certain similarities, some certain differences. First thing you realize that everything what you experience in the waking state was nothing but a dream. But when you wake up from the dream, the waking state, the dream continues, dream persists for some more time. Because the waking state body which you has still a lifetime because of the prarabdha karma. And till that lifetime is there, the body will continue to function. And as long as the body continues to function, the mind is continuing to operate and continue to project. But a difference has happened in your life that, this is a projection and you don't give any more reality to that. So that difference happens. The world doesn't disappear just like when you wake up from the dream state to waking state. From waking state of Maya to if you wake up to enlightened state, the world doesn't disappear. Because the continuation of the body-mind complex simply because of prarabdha karma. And why prarabdha karma is there? That's also by nature's design. The moment if somebody jnani wakes up and he dies, body-mind complex disappears. There is no benefit of awakening to the society or rest of the people in Maya. So, the nature ensures that there is a gap, time gap between enlightenment of a jnani and the eventual death of the body. And in that time, he will do some teaching and pass on that wisdom to others. For him, it is unreality. He is in a dreams-like situation. okay, and he knows he's in, it's like almost in a dream, you start recognizing, oh, I'm dreaming. A tiger is chasing you in a dream, and these are called lucid dreams, where you recognize, oh, tiger is chasing me, this is a dream. Mm-hmm. Like that, Nani also wakes up in the waking dream called Maya, and recognizes that it's a dream. Okay, now the dream is no longer affecting him, even though he may go through the motion of functioning in the dream world. Okay, this is called waking up. Now, what exactly happens in a waking up is two things happens. One is Brahma Satya, Jagan Mithya. The consciousness alone is real. Consciousness is non-dual. And world is unreal. This understanding becomes very, very clear. Okay. And there is a bliss. So, the bliss is similar to the bliss which you experience in deep sleep. The deep sleep, there is non-duality. There is no other. Okay. So, what I said, Nani experiences the bliss in the waking state also, even though there is a duality. Okay, the duality is there, but he knows the duality is unreal. So, there is a bliss of a deep sleep in the waking state also. The bliss is not disturbed. But of course, there will be some amount of ups and downs in the bliss in the waking state, because sense organs still will give the same input. If he sits in samadhi or meditation, their bliss will be more. But his bliss, his jnana will be uninterrupted in the waking state. So, there is a difference between this deep sleep and the enlightenment state. Deep sleep, there is a non-duality, okay, and bliss. But you wake up from deep sleep in the ignorance. Whereas in jnana, there is a non-duality in the waking state. That non-duality understanding has also gone to deep sleep state. So, when you wake up, Jnani wakes up and sleeps, still he is waking up as a Jnani, he doesn't become Ajnani. Any questions?